Live from Johannesburg, Miss World 2009. Albania, Angola, Argentina, Aruba, Australia, Austria, Bahamas, Barbados. Belarus, Belgium, Belize, Bolivia, Bosnia and Herzegovina, Botswana, Brazil, Bulgaria, Canada, People's Republic of China, Colombia, Costa Rica, Cote d'Ivoire, Croatia, Curaçao, Cyprus, Czech Republic, Denmark, Dominican Republic, Ecuador, Egypt, El Salvador, England, Ethiopia, Finland, France, Georgia, Germany, Ghana, Gibraltar, Greece, Guadeloupe. Guatemala, Guyana, Honduras, Hong Kong, China, Hungary, Iceland, India, Indonesia. Ireland, Israel, Italy, Jamaica, Japan, Kazakhstan, Kenya, Korea, Lebanon, Liberia, Lithuania, Luxembourg, Macedonia FYRO, Malaysia, Malta, Martinique, Mauritius, Mexico, Moldova, Mongolia, Montenegro, Namibia, Nepal, Netherlands, New Zealand, Nigeria, Northern Ireland, Norway, Panama, Paraguay, Peru, Philippines, Poland, Portugal, Puerto Rico, Romania, Russia, Scotland, Serbia, Sierra Leone, Singapore, Slovakia, Slovenia, South Africa, Spain, Sri Lanka, Suriname, Swaziland, Sweden, Tahiti, Tanzania, Thailand, Trinidad and Tobago, Turkey, Uganda, Ukraine, United States, Uruguay, Venezuela, Vietnam, Wales, Zambia, and Zimbabwe. Welcome your host for this evening from Phoenix Satellite Television, Angela Chow.
Hey, all you beautiful people! Miss World is back! I want to hear ya! That sounds pretty South African, pretty Joburg to me. All right, this is Miss World 2009, and you are joining us live from the most exciting city in the world, Johannesburg. How you feeling? That good, huh? Okay. We want to give a special thank you to His Worship, the Mayor of Johannesburg, Councillor Amos Masondo, for making us feel so welcome. And to SABC for this historic broadcast. Now, as you can see, a record of 112 nations have sent their beautiful representatives to this world-class African city. And tonight, one of these young ladies will be crowned before your eyes the new Miss World. I am joined, we're excited. I'm joined this evening by Steve Douglas, who, as the event director of Miss World, is well qualified to bring us the official view. Steve.
What a night, Angela. Yes, I'll be getting the views of the judging panel, explaining the judging process. And Angela, backstage, we have our co-host, a lady who herself is a former winner of a major international beauty title. She's also a UNICEF ambassador, Michelle McLean. Now, Michelle, you're backstage now. This must bring back some memories.
Hi there, Angela. Hi, Steve. Hi, everybody. It certainly brings back memories. But tonight, I'm going to be backstage capturing some of the tension, meeting some of the contestants, and chatting to some of their roommates and friends to find out who they think Miss World 2009 will be. I got to tell you, there's a lot of excitement and anticipation back here. I guess a lot of you out there wish you were in my position right now. Over to you guys.
Thank you, Michelle, and thank you, Steve. We're ready. How about you? Yeah, join us after the break for the biggest night of the year.
Music.
we've shared the spirit of togetherness through the African dance of Umoja. Now our contestants would like to share with you their cultures in a celebration of music, costume, and traditional dance. The Miss World 2009 contestants are pleased to present Dances of the World.
Dances of the World, a first in the Miss World final. I simply love those costumes. Stunning, stunning, stunning. But now it's time to meet our judging panel. Let's join Steve back on the arena floor. Steve.
Well, it's a tough job, isn't it? But someone's got to do it, and this is our judging panel this evening. We begin with somebody who doesn't need any introduction. She's a Bollywood superstar. She was Miss World 2000. She's the beautiful Priyanka Chopra. Judge number two, the man, the top fashion designer of South Africa. He dresses Miss World. He is JJ Schoeman. Another lady full of Miss World experience. She comes from China. She's the worldwide face of L'Oreal, as well as being Miss World 2007. Give it up for Zhang Zilin. Our next judge, judge number four, is chairman of the Miss World group and international president of Variety. She is Julia Morley. Our next judge, musical director for Dame Shirley Bassey, We Will Rock You, Grease, and many TV shows, including the Royal Variety Performance. Of course, he also writes the music for Miss World in his spare time. It's Mike Dixon. The lady responsible for bringing Miss World to Johannesburg. She's CEO of Johannesburg Tourism Company, representing the home of Miss World. Please welcome Lindiwe Mahlangu-Khwele. This man also needs no introduction to us at Miss World. He's the president of the World Travel Awards, Mr. Graham Cook. Well, here's a man looking more nervous than contestants, and I think I know why, because he's one of South Africa's leading producer directors, and tonight he's particularly excited because he's also the producer of Miss World 2009. Give it up for Warren Batchelor. So there we are. There's our judging panel. The decision on who is the next Miss World rests solely with them.
Legends Resort and Conservancy, another venture on the doorstep of Johannesburg. Okay, I've just been handed here our 10 judges' choices that will be joining our 6 fast-track winners in the Miss World semifinals. Are you ready? Yeah? Are you guys ready? Okay, good luck to our ladies. And our 7th semifinalist is... Please listen carefully as I announce. Korea. Our next place goes to Martinique. Take a deep breath, girls. Our next name is going to be Colombia. Our 10th semi-final place goes to Poland. Well done to our next country. She is Who's it gonna be? Brazil! The tension is mounting. And we have 5 more places, 5 more chances left for Miss World 2009. Ladies and gentlemen, are you ready? The next country I'm going to read out is... Bonsoir, France! The next country. And the 13th semi-finalist goes to a country in Asia. It is going to be Vietnam! All right, you've been watching them all month long. Who are you hoping for? We only have 3 places left, and so many beautiful contestants. Whatever are we going to do? But these are the judges' decisions. They have been interviewing them whole days on end, watching their every move, checking out their every action, and how they've reacted with all the other girls. So let's give them all a round of applause, all right? They've been working hard. But still, only 3 places left. And the first of those 3 places left goes to... Oh, it's nerve-wracking. Kazakhstan! Only 2 more chances left in the semifinals. They've all done so well. I really don't know how they pick them. It's too tough a choice. But the next country I shall name has a slight advantage because she's on home turf. South Africa! All right, little extra applause. Okay. Now, who has captured our one last semi-final place to keep their dreams alive? Well, I can tell you that the 16th semi-final place goes to ladies and gentlemen, Panama. Ladies and gentlemen, take a good look. You're 16 semifinalists.
Well, look at that. All of these ladies. And these judges down here have to make the decision on who is the next Miss World. Let's have a chat with some of them. We'll start with the producer of Miss World, Warren Batchelor. Warren, what are you looking for this evening in our contestants?
Well, you know, Steve, I'm looking for the whole package. But I must say this year, with the depth of talent we've had, this is superstar with a purpose, never mind beauty. And I'm looking for that superstar.
Thank you, Warren. Spoken like a true professional. I'm coming along the line here past Graham. To Lindiwe Mahango-Kwele, of course, hosting us this year. What does it mean to Johannesburg to host Miss World?
It is a great deal for us, Steve, because this is an opportunity for us to showcase our beauty of our culture, our dynamic and sophisticated infrastructure to the rest of the world, we've been able to host it successfully, and I think people need to make their decision to come and experience the beauty of South Africa during the World Cup. And I believe this is Africa's time, and we have showcased that we are able to deliver a world-class event. So we're very proud of ourselves, and we are saying the world, South Africa and Joburg is awaiting.
I think if you'd said that as a contestant, you'd have just won Miss World. Well spoken, Lindy Way. Wonderful. And now we come to our music director, Mike Dixon. Mike, you know what it's like to go on stage. How do you think these ladies have done today?
I think they've done fantastically, because it's really nerve-wracking up there. It's really scary. A billion people. It's really scary. But they have proved that this place, beauty with a purpose, Miss World, is just fantastic. It's gorgeousness, isn't it? Gorgeousness.
Yeah, this is the man, Mike Dixon. He invents a word, gorgeousness, just for Miss World. Thank you, Mike. Well, we're going to come along here now to a lovely lady, former Miss World, Zhang Zilin. This must bring back many memories for you. What are your feelings today?
I feel very excited. You know, 2 years ago, I was presenting China, and last year, I was handing over my crown to Ksenia. But today, it's my great honor to be a judge. I feel very happy.
And we're very, very happy to have you, Ksenia, and doing fantastically as the worldwide face of L'Oreal. And coming along to JJ now, this is fashion designer extraordinaire. JJ, what do you think of all the fashions you've seen this evening that the ladies are wearing?
I would like to congratulate the international designers, first of all, for doing an incredible job to bring such exquisite gowns over to South Africa. And also the local designers, thank you for doing such a great job.
Thank you, JJ. And finally, along to Priyanka, star judge this evening, star of Bollywood. Is this nerve-wracking, being a judge on Miss World?
I think I'm a lot more nervous than the girls right now. I mean, when we were calling out the top 16, I just remembered every single moment of every single feeling that I had when I was standing up there. Good luck, girls. You guys were all fantastic.
Yes, we echo that sentiment. Angela, we're going to go back to you. Our judges here are very impressed, not only with the contestants, but with you. You're looking gorgeous this evening.
Thank you very much, Steve. Aren't they wonderful, ladies and gentlemen? Thank you to the judges. And a big hand for all our contestants, if you will. But keep your eyes glued to our 16 semi-finalists as we choose the winner tonight of Miss World 2009. You know, she will also be a special guest at the FIFA World Cup final next year. And the whole of South Africa, as you can see, has just been united as it prepares to host the biggest event in world football. And one thing is for certain, let me tell you, Johannesburg is the gateway to your 2010 experience. If you are visiting Cape Town, Spear has got to be on your itinerary. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, this is the moment. There are only 7 places for the Miss World Final. And the judges have made their decision. Do you know who you're rooting for? Yeah? Yeah? I'm seeing flags. We're feeling the tension here at Gallagher Convention Centre. So here we go. The first Miss World 2009 finalist is... Colombia! The second Miss World 2009 finalist will be... Panama! We're holding our breaths here as we await the country name of our third finalist. Canada! And the fourth finalist Miss World 2009. We've got some excited people out there. Are you ready? Is it going to be another lucky red dress? It's going to be Mexico! And the fifth finalist goes to ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Gibraltar! The sixth finalist is, oh, there's only two places left. And the first one's gonna go to, go Bafana Bafana, South Africa! Okay, we have a party going on in the crowd. All right, but our 16 semifinalists now all deserve a round of applause, okay? Let's give them all a round of applause. However, there is only one more place left in our finals, and the judges have chosen that one special girl to give her one more place, the last place left in the finals. And that's going to be take a good look at them, girls. La Belle France! Ladies and gentlemen, congratulations to our seven finalists in Miss World 2009! Oh boy, the seven ladies are thinking, I've made it this far, yes. And for one of you, life is about to change. Do you have what it takes to win Miss World 2009? We're gonna give the girls a few minutes as we go backstage with Michelle and see what the other contestants think of our seven finalists. Take a look, Michelle.
Well, dresses are flying backstage here, tears all round, whether it's out of sadness or relief, possibly. And of course, there are hugs for all the contestants that have come thus far. But with me here is Jamaica. You are the roommate of Miss South Africa. Did you have any disagreements in your months staying together?
No, we didn't. We really hit it off. I mean, she's a really lovely girl, and I'm so proud of her.
Great. Miss Argentina, you are Miss Colombia's roommate. What do you think her chances are of winning?
She have muchas posibilidades. Big possibilities.
Right, well, thank you. And Australia, you are, is it Canada's roommate? Did you have any disagreements in the time that you were together?
No, it's actually really good because we're both early risers, so it didn't matter if one of us was blow drying our hair or anything, so no.
So that worked out perfectly?
Perfect.
And do you think that she thought that she'd make it this far?
I don't know. She's pretty special, so we'll see. Fingers crossed.
Great. Well, thank you, Australia. There you have it, ladies and gentlemen. Behind the scenes here, we got comments from the roommates of our seven finalists. And, of course, we're wishing them all the best of luck. Back to you guys.
Thank you, Michelle. And you know, every one of them is special, as they say in South Africa. 100%. Wouldn't you say? Yeah. Okay, but we are getting only one Miss World 2009, and we're waiting as the judges deliberate. They're discussing it now, and what we're going to talk about now is beauty with a purpose. Now, as you know, that has always been a central part of the Miss World Festival for so many years now, and Steve will explain further.
This year, Julia Morley launched the Variety International Children's Fund at the Miss World Charity Dinner in London. This visit also showcased the city of Johannesburg at the World Travel Market.
London launched the 2009 Miss World Festival as our contestants were the stars of a spectacular fundraising evening at the Grosvenor House Hotel in Park Lane.
At 6,500, 7,000...
Each contestant brought a gift from their country to be auctioned.
Well, $400,000 raised that evening, and a share of that money is being used here in Johannesburg to buy special needs beds and wheelchairs for Deboho Children's Home. We are pleased to announce that Julia Morley, on behalf of Variety International Children's Fund, is making a pledge to the Children's Home to the value of 500,000 rand. Now, one of our judges has become a Bollywood legend since she won the Miss World title in the year 2000. Who better than Priyanka Chopra to give a special message on behalf of all Miss Worlds, past and present? They're getting excited here in Johannesburg. Please, ladies and gentlemen, give it up for Priyanka Chopra.
Wow, isn't she beautiful? Say hi to Priyanka.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. It is such a pleasure to be back here on stage. For the purpose, Beauty with a Purpose was created by Julia Morley more than 30 years ago. It has become globally recognized for its outstanding contribution to support those most in need. The hundreds and millions of dollars raised have changed the lives of sick and disadvantaged children in every continent. I've had the privilege of working alongside Mrs. Julia Morley as she traveled the world in support of these children who needed the most help. She's truly an angel on earth.
Thank you so much, Priyanka. And you know, I've seen the work of this incredible organization, and I fully echo your words. Thank you. And thank you to Julia and all the girls that have worked together. Okay, girls and guys and South African and the world, when we come back, we are launching a new feature of Miss World as our seven finalists are put under the spotlight to answer a final question. Don't go away. We'll be right back from Johannesburg.
I shall announce the results in reverse order. In third place is South Africa. In second place is Miss Mexico. And winner of Miss World 2009 is Gibraltar.
Ladies and gentlemen, the 59th Miss World is Gibraltar!